Hey guys, Andy here, and today on Andy Talks to Pandy, I'm going to be introducing you to my new channel, coming up. Alright, I'm recording. Hey gang, Andy here. Welcome to a brand new episode of Andy Talks to Pandy. In today's episode, guys, I'm going to be introducing you to my new channel, Andy Japandy. I'm going to be giving you guys my vision of this channel moving forward, as well as introducing myself for those who don't know who I am and what I'm about. So that said, let's get on with the show. So yeah, welcome to my new channel, Andy Japandy. This channel is dedicated to all of my Japan-related content moving forward. It's going to contain my Andy Talks Japandy series, which you're watching right now, where I talk about various facets of my experiences in Japan. And it's also going to host my Andy Japandy series, where I show you around different parts of Japan, mainly focusing on the Tokyo / Kanagawa area. But I also want to move into other parts of Japan as well, but that's all dependent on budget and time. So for now, we'll just stick with the Tokyo / Kanagawa area. And there's a lot to explore out there, let me tell you. I also want to get some guests on the channel as well. Not just the big names that you all know and love, but also some lesser known names and even some people that aren't on YouTube just to share their experiences of their life in Japan. You might be wondering, like, why even bother to start this channel? I mean, the original Andy Japandy series and the original Andy Talks Japandy series, and even before that, the Andy Before Japandy series, was on my personal channel. So the reason I decided to splinter that off to here is for a couple reasons. One of them is just kind of the sign of the times, basically, just how YouTube is doing things. YouTube favors having channels with specific types of content, and also just viewing habits. I realize, especially considering my editing channel, edited by the Andy-san, seeing the success of that channel, where it's gone from here, I decided to splinter off my Japan-related content. Now, a little disclaimer, this channel is going to contain all new content. I'm not going to be moving any of my old stuff from my personal channel onto this channel. And I learned my lesson from last time. It was just a huge pain in the ass to like move everything over and get all the titles and the thumbnails and all that kind of stuff all taken care of. So why even bother? Let's just spend that time in making fresh, new quality Japan content. And so now I'll take this time to introduce myself for those who don't know who I am. First off, hi! My name is Andy. I've been on YouTube since 2006. I've been making regular content here on the platform since 2008. Before that, and even during that, I was also into blogging as well. And from 2010 to 2015, I was a member of the United States Navy. And from 2013 to 2015, before I got out, I was stationed out in Yokosuka, Japan. And I made a lot of videos of my time out there, both showing off different parts of Yokosuka, other parts in Kanagawa, parts in like Tokyo area as well. And I really enjoyed making those videos. They're a bit dated looking at them now, especially considering what I know about editing and cinematography and all this kind of stuff. So I definitely want to up my game with the new Andy Japandy series and show off what I've learned in these past 4, going on 5 years since I left the country. After I got out of the Navy, 2015, I came back here to the States and went to school up in Kalamazoo, Michigan. I went to Western Michigan University, go Broncos, and also went to Kalamazoo Valley Community College, KVCC, also known as Valley. Originally starting off in a management information systems major, I wasn't really too jazzed about it, to be honest. I just started it because I thought it was the logical thing to do, but my heart just really wasn't in it, and my grades definitely showed that. So I decided to switch majors and switched over to film, video, and media production out in Western. And that was more of a traditional media type major. So we were watching like films and stuff like that. And we were just kind of breaking down the different aspects of them and things like that. But we weren't really doing what I wanted to do, which was learn more about video editing and learning how to edit on Premiere Pro or Final Cut or Avid or just a myriad of different editors, DaVinci Resolve being the new hotness as of late. Over at Kalamazoo Valley, they were offering classes about the Adobe Suite, so I decided to transfer over there so I could learn more about how to be a better video editor and just learn how to do more things with the Adobe Suite and just become a much more efficient editor. During my time, out in Michigan. I was helping out a friend of mine. You might know him online as Tico Sam, my good old buddy. At the time, his hard drive had crashed and he was doing daily content and he didn't want to lose his streak. So I asked him if I could edit his stuff while he was getting his hard drive situation taken care of, because I wanted to help him out. And so after his hard drive had gotten fixed, he decided to take me on as his editor and edited his Tikio Play series, primarily his Tikio Rant series. I did a little bit with Tikio Cinema. So I basically took a lot of the then daily content off his plate so that way he could focus on his vlogs and other videos that he would personally edit. And from there, he introduced me to a lot of different people around Japan who needed editors, like Eric Surf 6, Brian from Ramen Adventures. And from there, I grew my clientele and became a fully fledged freelance video editor. It basically became a secondary job for me after a while, and it just kind of grew to the point to where I've been doing it essentially full-time for about a year now, the time of this recording. Between going to school, doing freelance work, I also sell stuff on eBay. And so at the end of 2017, I decided to take a break from college because I was in a really bad place mentally. I don't want to get too into it with this video, but I was in a bad place mentally and decided to just take a break from college for a little bit. Moved back in with my parents in 2018. Just kind of figure myself out, figure out what I really wanted to do, because I had really enjoyed my time out in Japan when I was stationed out in Yokosuka, and I really wanted to get back there. But my original plan was to just graduate from college, and then once I got my bachelor's degree, just move out to Japan to teach English like everybody else does. During this time, 2018, when I was kind of figuring myself out, I also helped my parents start up a video production company out in Ohio, Leading Line Productions. And we made a lot of great videos, but it never really took off like we had expected it to. Tension kind of grew in the house a little bit because I was still doing freelance work for everybody else in addition to the stuff for the production company. So I was just kind of trucking along, but tension grew in the house. At the end of 2018, moved in with my brother here in North Carolina, and I decided to go back to college, get my GPA up, and apply to a university out in Japan. And when I first applied to the university out in Japan, Lakeland University Japan to be specific, they denied me because my GPA was too low, obviously from all the mental health stuff that happened at the end of 2017. So I decided to take some classes here at the local community college to build my GPA back up. And after the summer semester, reapplied to the same college, and the dean was really impressed with my improvement and decided to give me a chance. And I've been officially accepted into Lakeland University Japan to start in the spring 2020 semester. So I'm very excited about that. I'm still going to community college to not only boost my GPA up further, but to help me save up thanks to the GI Bill and to just keep cracking on credits. And so I'll be moving out to Tokyo, Japan, the end of this year, 2019, to start school in Tokyo at the very beginning of 2020. So I'm really looking forward to it. It's gonna be a very exciting time. That's when the Olympics are gonna be out there. It's gonna be a huge boom in tourism, and there's gonna be a lot of interest in Japan in 2020 and in subsequent years as well. And I definitely want to make the videos that I wanna make out there and to show people just how awesome Japan can be. But in addition to showing off all the cool parts of Tokyo and all this other stuff, I also want to talk about the more practical aspects of living in Japan. Talking about the cost of living as a student in Japan. Talk about different ways that you could save money out in Japan. Different ways you can make money out in Japan, aside from just English teaching. You know, there's a lot of different aspects of Japan life that hasn't really been talked about on YouTube. And I want to talk about those things because I think that they're very important, especially for people who want to come over to Japan, not just to tour around Tokyo and Kyoto and Osaka and stuff like that for a couple weeks, but if they want to come here as a student or come here to work. There's a lot of aspects to living in Japan that, like I said, just aren't covered. And I wanna cover those. Really looking forward to making more videos on this channel. I have a whole bunch of different ideas for Andy Talks Japan-y before I move out to Japan. And even after I move out to Japan, a lot of stuff I wanna talk about. So I hope you guys enjoy the content of this channel moving forward. With that said, this is the Andy-san, signing for now. And as always, we'll see you next time. Catch you later, guys. Bye.